So you have strong enforcement action, POA doing strong audits, and if anyone really breach or steal your money from the pork barrel, what you should do is you deal with it properly, sending these people to jail. So that one is relative, you do have the will or the ability to tackle it. But election is a problem. 100% is not.
Thank you, Prasenko. We will request the students to listen to the question of one student. Lamberto Dienz, the third. This is a very good question. Does giving an incentive in every transaction eradicate corruption? Incentive. How is it? Professor.
I was former.
Former professor. Does giving incentive in every transaction eradicate corruption?
Giving an incentive to every transaction or business transaction?
Perhaps
give me an example.
What he means is if it will be conducted properly, then what is saved, the person pays what is saved in a public road project, for example, can be given to the officials concerned.
Well, in the private sector, they must be very clear about incentive. The incentive will be properly down in the law and your internal procedure that you should only receive the salary. Okay? So anything over and above the salary, you are not really entitled to receive.
Another question from a student. Actually, two questions. One asks for opinion, the other asks for suggestions. First, suggestions on how an ordinary citizen can help combat corruption. And the opinion part, what's your opinion on the recommendation of former Ombudsman Mercedes Gutierrez? Does it send a good or bad anti-corruption campaign?
What can an individual do? Of course, the first thing you should do is you should not be involved in bribery.
In the chart, remember the chart, the first part of your presentation?
Yes, there's an ask me a comment on the new one, but on the old ombudsman, yeah.
Yeah.
But my only comment is that the resignation will create an opportunity for this country to renew the fight against corruption. The president and the new ombudsman can now really get their hands and actively try to pursue a place to change the whole scenario. It must be put in that sense. Yeah. Individually, I know mercy. So I know comment.
Thank you for that, Mr. Book. In the chart you have shown earlier, what are the bases used to determine how corrupt an administration is? Do you have any thoughts on that?
This is a question that if you can get the answer, you can get an Oscar. You got a Nobel Prize. How to measure corruption in this country? On what basis can you say that Philippines is more corrupt than Indonesia or vice versa? On what basis can you say that? There's never a way to measure corruption because corruption is a secret crime. So the only thing people come up with is basically a perception. So they're not reliable. But perception is correct in the sense that if it generally is right, that the perception generally, but precisely cannot be right. So you can say that both Indonesia and Philippines have a corruption problem, but don't believe if anyone tells you that Philippines is more corrupt than Indonesia or vice versa. Also, how can you prove that? There's no way you can prove it.
I have another question on that follow-up, Mr. Cook, because when you were presenting the chart, it occurred to my mind also that is it possible that the reason for the high rating of the president is the people were trying to mirror the full expectation of the new president? So it's not really a reflection of the real state of corruption in the country.
Absolutely, it's the public expectation. And that's why I said it in other lectures. for those law enforcement agencies. You only have a honeymoon period of not more than 1 year. If during the 1 year nothing happened, you can see this will slip by now. Because people will get totally disoriented, and then the people just infect and become worse as before. What you are having is just a kind of
I don't want to, for you to ask to answer this question, because there are legal implications to it. I will read it anyway for the benefit of the one who wrote it. Regarding the compacts in the ZTE broadband deal, is it time that JMA will not be guilty of graft since anyway support of the deal? It's more of a legal question. There are no more questions from the audience, but there's a question from Dr. Covino.
I have a question. In 1961, we had a very distinguished professor, Onofre D. Corbus. He finished from Harvard, he wrote books, he became Minister of Education under martial law. But at that time, when he was lecturing to our class, he said, he wrote an essay and he tested it on us as students. His thesis was, graft and corruption continues to exist in the Philippines because while it is illegal, it is not unethical. Can you comment on that from your observations? While graft and corruption is not illegal, it's against the law. We have anti-graft and corrupt practices law. It is not unethical because people expect to be helped. Relatives who are less endowed expect their relatives in high positions to help them, etc.
This is definitely true in all the corrupt countries. And this was definitely true in Hong Kong when I was young. It's basically people accept wrong way of life. This is totally untrue.
Thank you very much, Mr. Cook. From what we heard from you, it seems that the most important thing here is political will. Therefore, we have to strengthen our electoral process, because if there is accountability to the ballot, then perhaps there will be more political will in the part of the officials. And secondly, as a priority, would be to strengthen our audit system. This is what I gathered from what you said. So that in the end, all the other corruptions can be prevented through the audit system. And one thing is that you raise the level of our confidence as far as fighting corruption is concerned. If there is anything that you have given us besides the knowledge, you gave us the hope that perhaps the Philippines is not far behind as far as coming forward to combat corruption, and for that we will not doing justice to ourselves. We will thank you from the bottom of our heart for giving your time and the expertise, the wealth of experience, and your best wishes that perhaps the Philippines as a neighbor country will also raise that achieve of status, which you hope for every Filipino and citizen of the world to enjoy from a good governance. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.